Today on Samcraft, I'm going to be bringing you guys along as I take a 3D scanner, in this case, the Einstar Vega all-in-one 3D scanner. We're gonna scan this little DeWalt tape measure. We're gonna put it into our computer, do our magic, and end up 3D printing myself two extra tape measures, because honestly, we can never have enough in a shop. Hey guys, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. That's right, today's video is going to be about 3D scanning. Hopefully you're interested. If you are, you're still here, I guess you might be. I'm basically going to bring you guys along with the Einstar Vega, take a look at it, show you guys how to set it up, what it takes to calibrate. We're going to scan the tape measure, we're going to process it, edit it in the computer, and then we're going to 3D print it in the end to compare our results. There will be timestamps down below if you want to jump around to certain portions, whether it be calibration, machine overview, scanning, post-processing in the computer, 3D printing, or just seeing the final results. I put those there to help you out. Also, it's worth mentioning that Einstar did send this scanner to me to use and review in this video, but they did not dictate or tell me what I can, cannot say, or tell me what to do with it. So keep that in mind as you watch the video and when it comes to your decision making on whether or not you should purchase this or any other product. So the power switch is over here to the right. I'm gonna press and hold it, and we'll go ahead and boot up the scanner. Now that the scanner has booted up, you're able to see the screen and the display. What you're seeing here in the middle is what it is scanning. So as things move around, that center portion will change. I'll give you a brief overview of the menu and what you can see, but do realize I'm not an expert with this just yet. So there may be things that I'm missing or things that as you use it or see other content videos, you'll learn even more. Over here to the left is where you can control a couple of things, such as automatic screen brightness, and you can manually control the brightness on the camera. This will help you get better scans with darker objects or lighter objects. The second menu down is where you can set your working distance. If you know you're only going to be within, let's say, 110 millimeters, 240 millimeters away, you can change that if you want. That controls the depth of field, so that's nice. The little color wheel down here, when you tap it, you have the option to show texture display and also the data quality indicator. So if I turn off texture display, our scan is black and white. It's just the 3D printed object and not texture. I like to see the texture and also capture texture because it helps on post-processing and cleanup on the computer. Over here to the right, this little green slider will tell you if you're too far away or too close to the object you wish to scan. For example, it shows far right now, but if I move this paper close, it's telling us, whoa, 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 that's too close. So as I move this, you see that little green bar to the right moving? That's telling us where the sweet spot is for scanning and to get the best results. Over here to the right is another menu where you have advanced settings, such as your scan settings, resolution, whether to acquire your texture or not, align mode, such as feature alignment, texture alignment, or marker alignment. And then moving over here to the portrait settings, we have settings for that as well. So I'm going to leave it on object and close this menu. Here on the play button, this is what you press when you want to start scanning. You guys will see that here in a little bit. And then down here to the right, the little three blocks is what you click on when you want to see things you have scanned. And this is the internal memory of the scanner. So for example, let's go down to, let's say this one. This is a file that I scanned already. I can pinch zoom with the screen and then move it around with single finger. This is a treasure chest box that I 3D printed for my son and figured I would play around with scanning it. And you can kind of see the results here. Obviously, I didn't do a great job as far as capturing it completely all the way around because this part is open and hollow, but it does at least give you an idea of the details. And you can at least see how this touchscreen interface is actually really cool. It's really nice to have all of this on the scanner itself. This is the mesh display. If I want to change it to show points, I tap on that right there and it changes over to the points display. See how it's a bunch of little dots? So whatever you like, You can do editing within here as well. So let's go back to mesh because I like to do that better. I'm going to tap on the scissor icon to the left. And now what we need to do is move this around, zoom in, and if I click or tap drag, see how there's a box? If I do this, it now selects that in red, and then I can tell it to delete it, and it takes it out. So this is a way of editing your object or your mesh within the scanner, which is really nice, because in this manner, you don't necessarily need a computer to do this, although honestly, a computer is the easiest thing to do. So closing out of that model, we're back here at all the files, and that's really cool. Again, we have the storage here, and then clicking on this arrow, we're back to the main screen. So there you go, guys. There's the overview of scanner menu and functionality, at least the screen and what you can do. What I want to do next is go through the calibration, which for that, we're going to be using this glass card that comes with the scanner that has the dots on both sides. We're going to follow the actual on-screen prompts and directions and scan the calibration card to recalibrate the scanner. Calibration is something that you have to do kind of often with this scanner, unfortunately, but when you do it, it does improve your accuracy and the scanner's performance, so it's one of those necessary evils. Okay, let me see if I can show you guys the calibration procedure. So up here at the top left, I'm going to tap on recalibrate and choose start calibration. It tells us to make sure the lenses are clean. We don't put our fingers there. Yep, we're good to go. It also showing the different cards, blah, blah, blah. I'm ready to go beyond this. I think I have to wait regardless. Okay, now we are ready to begin. Over here to the right is where it shows what orientation the card needs to be. So I'm taking the card, putting it flat on the table, just like that. And now what you want to do is line up your dots on the screen with the target, and you're going to move it up and down until the blue rings disappear, and that tells you that it is scanned and got it where it wants for that stage. Okay, so at this point it's done with that portion. Now it wants me, as shown in animation over here, it wants me to take the card, use the little bracket, and hold it up so now it's at an angle this way. Now we take the scanner, we hold the scanner level, moving it over this way a little bit. Again, you want to watch your screen, you want to line up your dots, and you're going to go down and up until you have all the blue rings scanned and they disappear. Good. Now we're going to rotate this card 90 degrees and repeat the process. All right. Once you have finished the HD calibration, it immediately takes you into the fast mode. Pro tip on this one, you flip the card over, but you have got to get really far away from this. So what I like to do is put this card on something about knee height, height of your kneecaps, because you're gonna have to raise it up quite a bit. Okay, so you guys are way up there on top of my shelf. And again, this is pretty low because what we have to do now is start calibration. And right about here, that's as close as I can get to the board. So now I've got to go up. So this will show you, if this was a lot taller like it was before, this would be well above my head. And I wouldn't be able to see the screen whenever I capture the blue rings to know that I'm done or not. All right, at that point, that's how far you raise it. So what is that? From 2 to 3 feet away from the object, roughly? At this point, we just repeat the same thing. We got the card propped up. We're raising it up, lowering it down, whatever it takes in order to get the rings on the screen captured, and so we can move to the next step. So once you're done with the HD and the fast mode, you now have to wait because it's generating your calibration result. And once it's done doing this, it'll tell you if it's good, you may now use the scanner, or if it's not good and you have to repeat the steps. Thankfully, it tells me the calibration was successful. I'm going to click on apply and it's going to reboot the scanner. Then we will be ready to use it. While it applies the calibration results, I do like that they give you a nice felt bag to put this card in because these dots are stickers and they can get rubbed off. You definitely want to keep this plus your little plastic kickstand, I guess, in the case. But again, it's nice that this also comes with a nice case so that everything stays in there just pretty as you please, just about pretty as you please. It is also nice that the case does have storage area for the calibration card. The little dots go in this pocket, and it is a really good, I guess, semi-hard shell case that is very nice, which is what you would expect for the money, but it does give room for everything you need to keep on hand to stay close and stored as well. All right, all right. So our scanner has calibrated, rebooted, and ready to go. So what I want to do now is actually get into the actual meat and taters of the video, and let's scan something. So for this test, what I want to do is scan a tape measure. This is a DeWalt 9-foot tape measure, just a little object, regular, normal thing. I want to scan this, bring it into the computer, clean up any kind of artifacts. We'll see how good it does. But then I want to 3D print this to compare reality from scanned object. I want to see how well this scanner can replicate and reproduce this tape measure, and that's what we're going to be doing next. This is a 3D scanning turntable. It has little reflector marker dots on it. It also has a little motorized portion here that you can plug up and power and will automatically rotate. This did not come with the Einstar. This I purchased separately, and I definitely recommend you get it because these are very, very useful and handy to get. So I've got my table there. I'm gonna put my object right on top of it. You can kind of see a little bit of the tape measure. I gotta go back and forth, find that sweet spot, and we're gonna be going around it and scanning. Now, one thing to note, if you look at that graphic, you see how the silver belt clip is totally missing? That's because it's reflecting and not being absorbed by the scanner, I don't know, light waves, and it doesn't see it. So in this instance, I need to hit this guy with some scanning spray first to make sure this detail scans and I don't have voids that are going to cause issues with my end product for scanning. As far as scanning spray, this is what I purchased and use. This also does not come with this scanner. This is from Amazon. It's nothing special other than it is made for 3D scanners and it was a highly rated product. So I'll put a link to this in the description below along with this turntable, since both these items are not included with this scanner, but you're absolutely going to need them in my experience. In order to spray this, I'm going to take it outside because this does create a little bit of cloud of dust and I don't want it getting in my shop. So I'm going to spray it, but be right back here in 1 second. Here you can see the results of the scanning spray. It puts a white powder coating on your object, but this will evaporate. So let's go ahead and put it here in place. Now let's grab the scanner and let's start scanning. First of all, let's see, did that spray actually make it to where it sees the belt clip? It's gonna be hard for you to see that, but yes, it does see it now. All right, let's test out how well this does work with a turntable, scanning spray on my device, and the scanner on its tripod, because this should be best case scenario. All right, so we got everything set up. We'll go ahead and click here to start scanning. Here it tells us hold steady. Once it locks in, say it says start scan now, I'm gonna plug in the USB cord for the turntable over here, just barely off camera, and let's see how well it does. So the turntable is on its absolute slowest speed setting. And as it goes around, so far it's looking all right. We're able to see it's capturing the red dots, which are the markers on the turntable, but it's also capturing the texture of the tape measure, so that is good. It is almost finished one full rotation, so that is good. So far we've not had it lose its tracking. All right, I'm gonna unplug the turntable because we just finished one full revolution of the turntable and it did great. It did not lose its tracking. All right, at this point, looks good. We'll go ahead and stop the scan and do a check mark until we are done. And then at the top right, I'm gonna tap on complete, and that will save it to the internal memory. Now that my scans are done, what I could do is spend some time inside the scanner here with its touchscreen and edit my meshes and try and get some optimized results that way. But what I prefer to do is take the scanner, connect it to my computer, and using the software from Einstar, edit it in the computer. It's not required. That's why this is sold and advertised as a, you know, all-in-one, no computer required type thing, but it's just a lot easier, in my book at least, to edit those on the computer. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna attach it to the computer, I'm gonna download my models, load it into their software. I will start by optimizing the meshes. I will get rid of any things that don't need to be there, trim them out, optimize them, fill in any kind of holes that I need to with the software tools. And then at that point, what I'll probably do is export those to another file format, load them into my CAD software. In this case, I may just use Tinkercad, keeping it really basic for everyone, the free CAD software being Tinkercad. Then I'll see if I can put these together and end up with one 3D all the way around cohesive replication of this tape measure. Because after that, I'm gonna drop it in my slicer, 3D print it, and we'll see how true to reality did I get with the scanning, the editing, the printing, and everything in the end. All right, these guys are off the 3D printer, and let's go ahead and take a look at them. So right off the bat, between the white and the gray, there's not a whole lot of differences, with the exception of you can see my joint line on the white tape measure because I had to splice those two models together. Otherwise, as far as the detail, they are very, very similar. Perhaps the gray has a little bit more detail when it comes to the back side of the tape measure where the DeWalt logo is on the opposite side of that belt clip. But honestly, between the two, they look pretty close. You also got to see that it took me quite a while to do all of the computer work, to go from the scans inside the 3D scanner through the software to the actual outputs to my slicing program took about an hour. Now that's probably because I'm not super well versed at this, but it still was a lot of work. More than I would have expected, and maybe more than you would expect, but at the same time, this may just be par for the course. So definitely that's something worth keeping in mind. If you're thinking about 3D scanning, scanning the object is apparently the easy, fast part. So this point is where I ask you, what did you think? But I really want to know if you yourself have experience with 3D scanning and you consider yourself pretty well versed. Did I do this correctly? Am I missing some obvious point? Because I'm not sure. Maybe this is just the way it is with 3D scanning and I'm just learning that it's going to be more time spent on your mesh file edits or whatever work you do after the scanning, and it's not as, you know, portrayed online, so to speak. I have used this for a handful of different projects and I've had pretty good results overall, although today's example, scanning the tape measure, has been pretty much par for the course for my experiences over about the 10 projects I've made with the scanner. So again, if you got experience, leave them for me down below. Also, if you are curious, you know, is Sam just missing something obvious? Be sure and check out those comments too, because there will be people down there, I hope, leaving us really good information. Otherwise, if you want to check out the Einstar Vega, I'll put a link to it down below. In addition, I'll put a link to the turntable and the scanning spray, especially since they're not included, because if you go down the route, you're going to need those too. And anything else I find useful or think you might want to see will be linked there as well. Otherwise, I appreciate you guys hanging out with me in the shop today. Take care, and I'll see you guys next time.